So until we get our budget back on track, I will continue to order the rougher, scratchier, more affordable single-ply bathroom tissue instead of the popular luxury two-ply. Camilla, how about a little support?
I know, Dave, but I just had a drink of this generic soda that you've been buying, and all I can think of is how to get your head through this tiny little opening so I can drown you.
Perhaps I can help. Have you considered removing Dave's glasses?
Come on, Dave's just doing his job. Although I'm not sure putting a television on top of a typewriter necessarily makes it a computer.
Did anybody bother to look over the new story ideas?
I did, and I think that this interview with the Titanic survivors is great. I'll take it.
The Titanic happened, what, 80-something years ago? What's next, an expose on President Harding's mistress?
If I say so. Now, as you all know, the new Titanic movie premieres on Friday, and I thought, why not escort the five remaining survivors so that they could relive every horrifying, terror-stricken moment for the enjoyment of our readers.
Sorry I'm late, but I had the most incredible luck this morning. This radio station had this calling contest, and I was
Listen, Camilla, if you're done with me, I got a lot
to say.
I don't have anything to do. I just don't want to listen to his blah, blah, blah.
So the DJ takes caller number 12, which is me. And the question is the weather phenomenon El Nino. What does it mean in Spanish? And I say the little one. Because I used to date this girl from Acapulco, and that was her nickname for... for Rhea Coleman. But isn't it ironic? I mean, here everyone complains about El Nino. I mean, the floods, the drought, the death, and I win a great new pair of sneakers because of it.
And some people say God doesn't have a plan.
Ah, but he does. And it goes by the name of El Nino.
Dave, before I drink it, what exactly is milk with a Y?
It's 19 cents a gallon, so back off.
Tonight, make a double date with Mal. He's mutinous in The Bounty. And as Tim, he's not just a hunk. He's what we all could use, a handyman. Later, things have really changed, but that's nothing new for Felicity. 'Twas the weekend before the holidays, and definitely time to chill. We, Women's Entertainment.
They're here to make sure you're on your best behavior.
Real women, real cases. Diva Detectives.
Wednesdays at 8:30 Eastern on We, Women's Entertainment.
Never send a man to do a diva's job.
Man, I don't know why she's tripping. It was only weed. I only tried it once.
You're grounded. That means no phone.
Mom, come on.
Don't even think about it.
She doesn't love being tough. She's tough because she loves. She is the enforcer. And she knows she can make a difference.
When I say no weed, I mean no weed.
Yeah, you want to hit this and get grounded again? Nah, man. I'm cool.
The enforcer. She's more than a hero. She's
a good mom.
You're more powerful than you know.
The Sears Great Saturday Sale. Saturday only, 7 to 10 a.m., get an extra 10% off everything, even on sale prices. All the best gifts, all at Sears. The latest electronics are on sale. Find hundreds of tools on sale. Get 50 to 60% off all fine jewelry. And save on all jeans, all sweaters, all coats. Extra 10% off everything, even on sale prices. Come in this Saturday. Doors open at 7 a.m. It's the Great Saturday Sale, only at Sears. Give the good life.
Forget, your laugh lines are sexy lines.
Kahlua, unleash.
Shh, they're coming.
Oh, what a time for a cold.
Nose is running, head's all blocked up. I need some Alka-Seltzer Plus.
Only Alka-Seltzer Plus has an effervescent cold-fighting formula that breaks up your worst cold symptoms fast. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
Every home has them. Tough marks on walls. How'd those get there? Scuffs on floors. And that tough dirt you never thought you could easily clean. Until now. Introducing Mr. Clean Magic Eraser. There's nothing else like it. You just use water. Then Mr. Clean Magic Eraser goes to work.
Amazing.
But wait. There's more. Its innovative material gets into those tiny surface textures that trap dirt and grime and magically erases it away. Watch this. Say bye-bye, crayon. Your masterpiece. Use Mr. Clean Magic Eraser again and again until it disappears.
That was so easy.
Here's what other folks say about Mr. Clean Magic Eraser.
It takes marks off the floor, off the walls, off shoes. I think it will change the way you clean.
It does like the name says, it erases things like you would not believe.
Go to this website now to get a coupon that can save you up to 50% off your next purchase of a 2-count package of Mr. Clean Magic Eraser.
Wow, did you know that the oldest survivor of the Titanic is 104 years old? I mean, can you imagine being born before there were airplanes? Of course, I guess, you know, that's why she took the boat.
10 minutes with those people and you want to take a bullet.
Why is that, Jake? Because they're old?
Yeah. Whenever I call my grandmother, it's always the same. We say hello, she rambles on about the weather for 20 minutes, and then we hang up. You know, if her forecasts weren't so damn accurate, I wouldn't even pick up the phone.
Well, at least she doesn't ruin your holidays. Every year, I fly home for Thanksgiving because my grandfather guilts me into it. Then when I do get there, he spends the entire time cheating at Scrabble. When I call him on it, he yells, "Thanksgiving's over! Get out!"
Okay, you guys are exactly what's wrong with society.
I am so tired of hearing that.
Elderly are a resource, like a living history. I mean, if you guys would take the time out and listen to them, maybe you would learn from their life experiences.
Learn what? How to schedule your entire life around The Price is Right?
You have no idea how lucky you are. You still have your grandparents. I never got a chance to know mine.
My grandmother lives with me. Where I come from, we invite our elders into our homes instead of turning them out to pasture.
See, this is exactly what I'm talking about.
We talk, we learn about our wonderful past, how wonderful things were in the old days, and how everything went to hell when the white-skinned devils came from the West. We never let her out in public.
Okay, but you still continue to live with her?
Well, yeah, she owns the house.
Late one last night, Jake?
Actually, I turned in early, but I had this really disturbing dream about someone in the office.
Was it Nora?
No, it wasn't Nora, but it was sexual.
Oh, unbelievable. This happens to me every job I've ever had. All right, is it the dream where I dance seductively like this? Oh, yeah. Come on, do it.
Stop dancing. It wasn't about you. It was about Camilla.
I had a dream about Camilla once, but it wasn't sexual. She had the body of a spider, and she bit my head off after a budget meeting.
And you don't think that's sexual?
Thanks, Harris.
Well, in my dreams, Camilla starts rubbing my shoulders and telling me how tense I am, and then she says she wants to work late and takes me in her office where she takes me in her office. Right on her desk.
Hey, anybody see that ball game last night?
What ball game?
I don't know, any ball game.
Anyway, the sex was great. I mean, it was the best sex I ever had. Now, like, I can't stop thinking about her. What do you make of that, Harris?
Hey, anyone see that ball game last night?
Hello. Yes, this is Bradley Crosby. I did? Great. Okay, well, I'll be by tomorrow to pick up my prize. Okay, bye. Oh, don't you just love El Nino? That was the soup exchange. I dropped my business card into a fishbowl. Guess what I won?
Soup.
Okay, but if I had won the drawing at Bed Bath & Beyond, you wouldn't be looking like such a genius right now, would you?
Nora,
The Titanic survivors are going to be here any minute. Sorry to say we were only able to get four instead of five, damn it.
Oh, no, who got the other one?
God.
What the hell was that?
What was what?
You were checking Camilla out.
No, I wasn't.
Yeah, you were.
Please, she bent over and I looked her up and down, and if that's checking someone out, well, then I don't know what is.
Here's the booze. What are you looking at? Canned bourbon from Iran is just as tasty as the premium brands.
Insert oily rag here, light and throw.
Okay, everybody, watch your step. Ladies and gentlemen, the Rolling Stones.
Victor Hazeltine, lifeboat number 9.
Hi, I'm Nora Wilde. Welcome. And listen, I heard about your fellow survivor friend who, well, you know, stopped surviving. I'm sorry about that.
So you were on the Titanic, huh? Lifesaver?
Like I haven't heard that one a few times in the last 85 years.
Excuse me, everyone, why don't we head into the conference room and we'll do the interview in there, okay? Hi, you must be Nigel. I'm Nora.
Don't waste your time. It's like talking to pudding.
Even with all the confusion that night, the one thing I'm absolutely sure about is that boat was big.
Big?
Yes, almost Titanic in size. Wouldn't you say, Victor?
Yeah, it was big.
Edwina, we haven't heard from you yet.
Well, as I sat huddled there in the lifeboat, I remember watching that great ship going down and thinking, yes? How unseasonably warm the weather was. Why, if it hadn't been for all the explosions and screaming, it would have been a perfectly pleasant evening.
Okay, here's something. Is it true that several men dressed up as women in order to get on the lifeboats first?
My father was not a brave man. But to his credit, he spent the rest of his life as a woman. Which was about 20 minutes after they lifted his skirt and tossed him overboard. No, but I'm bored, too.
Okay, we seem to have gotten a little off track here. So why don't we all close our eyes? And that's good. Nigel, you're ahead of me on this one. And let's travel back. Back to 1912.
Ooh, I just thought of something.
Good, good, Edwina. Why don't we all just settle down and listen to what Edwina has to say? What is it, Edwina?
I shoplift. There, I said it.
Lord, that was a marathon session. How did it go? Give me your juiciest morsel.
Keep your purse away from Edwina. Look. Camilla, I know I don't have a whole lot just yet, but I think they're really starting to warm up.
They were fished out of the icy water 85 years ago. Shouldn't they be warm by now?
They're getting there. Edwina, honey, no. Stay out of my desk, okay? Okay, everybody, let's go. We don't want to be late. I think that maybe the premiere will really help to jog their memory, you know?
It's already 3:30. Do we have time to stop for dinner?
Yeah, well, we would have if Victor hadn't pressed every floor.
I'm not hungry.
Jake, how's your JFK Jr. story coming?
Not great. No one will confirm anything. I'm really frustrated.
Wow. And tense. I'll tell you what. I'm going to be here a little late tonight. Maybe we could bat around some ideas.
Okay.
Is that my pen? It is. Well, you're a naughty boy. You know, if you want something, just ask for it. So, see you in my office? Say in half an hour?
rain. I don't know how you can see where you're going.
I don't need to see, Nora. El Nino is watching over us.
Why aren't we there yet? We're not lost, are we?
No, we're not lost. Bradley, how much longer?
I don't know. I think we're lost.
Welcome to Pasadena. Turn around, Bradley.
Great. We're lost.
Bradley, I said turn around.
Okay, I will turn around. If you don't mind, I'd like to use an off-ramp instead of flipping us over the center divider. Somebody threw a Tums at me.
Okay, there is no need to throw antacid. I know. Why don't we do what my family did on long drives when I was a girl?
Try to ditch you at a gas station?
No. Play Who Am I?
We play that every day.
I hate the way this kid with the beard drives. Gas brake, gas brake. Might as well let the girl take the wheel.
You know what? That's it. I have had enough criticism out of you, okay? Well, I think I speak for everyone here when I say, thank you, El Nino.
What the hell are you thanking El Nino for? Bradley, we almost got killed.
Almost, Nora. Almost.
Friendship rule number one.
I'm only doing this for you. You know, Bert, I'm buying like a tenth of that.
Two Guys and a Girl, coming up next on WE, Women's Entertainment.
They say laughing burns 120 calories an hour. That means that watching sitcoms on WE from 6 to 8 will burn 240 calories.
I feel like an enormous weight has just been lifted.
That's half a cup of ice cream or one slice of pizza.
Now, if I tape and watch each show twice...
WE Laugh, weeknights at 6 p.m., only on WE.
You know when you really like someone? You want to see more of them?
You'll marry me.
You hang on their every word.
That is so beautiful.
Watch their every move. Notice what they're wearing. We understand. One star, two movies, airing back to back. It's a double date every Friday night at 8 Eastern. Tonight, make a date with Mel Gibson. Right here on WE.
The Sears Great Saturday Sale. Saturday only, 7 to 10 a.m. Get an extra 10% off everything, even on sale prices. All the best gifts, all at Sears. The latest electronics are on sale. Find hundreds of tools on sale. Get 50 to 60% off all fine jewelry. And save on all jeans, all sweaters, all coats. Extra 10% off everything, even on sale prices. Come in this Saturday. Doors open at 7 a.m. It's the Great Saturday Sale, only at Sears. Give the good life.
Flexibility. It's what makes Remington's new Smooth and Silky Ultra our best shaver ever. Its exclusive UltraFlex shaving system hugs every curve for our closest, most comfortable shave. Remington, America's number one brand.
Man, I don't know why she's tripping. It was only weed. I only tried it once.
You're grounded. That means no phone.
Mom, come on.
Don't even think about it.
She doesn't love being tough. She's tough because she loves. She is the enforcer. And she knows she can make a difference.
When I say no weed, I mean no weed.
Yeah, you want to hit this and get grounded again? Nah, man. I'm cool.
The enforcer. She's more than a hero. She's
a good mom.
You're more powerful than you know.
What if you became your daughter and your daughter became you?
Get away, you clone freak!
Don't you use that tone with me.
Featuring freaky fun DVD extras, including bonus alternate endings and much more.
Shut up.
Freaky Friday. Own it today on Disney DVD and video.
I hate colds.
Colds are nasty.
They're mean.
Colds are rotten day and night.
No product works harder than Tylenol Cold day and night.
I gotta be sharp, not stuffed.
I want to sleep soundly, no coughing.
It gives you the complete symptom relief you need when you need it. A non-drowsy formula for your day and one that lets you rest at night.
I can breathe.
I can breathe.
I can breathe. No more sneezing.
No more sniffling.
No more misery.
Tylenol Cold day and night.
It feels so good to be better.
A woman in Michigan with diabetes actually carries 6 jelly beans in case her blood sugar drops.
We gave her this tip in our newsletter. We're MP Total Care. We also helped her save money by providing home delivery of leading brands of testing supplies. With no money up front and no claim forms to fill out, and Medicare may actually pay for it, we can help you too. We're your partners in health at MP Total Care. Call for this free booklet. Let us help you control your diabetes. Together, we can do it.
1-800-PETMEDS, America's most trusted pet pharmacy, with some cold weather tips for your pets.
To minimize risk of infestation, it's important to keep your pet on both heartworm and flea and tick prevention all year long. Also, colder weather can mean painful bones and stiff joints. Supplements such as Cosequin will help keep pets active and pain-free. Finally, your veterinarian should examine your pet once a year.
1-800-PETMEDS delivers all pet medications, guaranteeing the lowest price with free shipping. Order online or call now.
What's the damage, Captain?
I'm not your captain, okay? Besides a crack in the roof, we've got a blown right front tire.
Oh, damage to starboard side!
I can't believe it. We barely hit that ice truck, and look at this. I mean, this is supposed to be like the best-built van in the world, and there's water coming in everywhere.
Help is on the way.
Well, you've heard that before. Man the lifeboats.
We're in a minivan out. There are no lifeboats.
Good God, when will they learn?
Women and children first.
Give me your dress.
Yeah, take off your dress.
Wait a second. You finally say something and that's it?
I only speak when I have something important to say.
Okay, that's enough. Look, I know that you're all disappointed about missing the premiere, but today hasn't exactly turned out the way I wanted it to either. So, instead of all the bitching and moaning...
She said bitching.
I'm going to tell you to do something that somebody probably told you to do 85 years ago in your life, folks. Sit down and shut up.
Listen. The band is still playing.
That's the radio.
What are you doing?
I know, the mood doesn't strike me very often, but when it does, I take advantage of it.
The mood?
To clean. What's going on with you, Jake?
Well, there is something that's bothering me, but it's kind of personal.
Oh, all right. Take a seat. Give you 2 minutes, and then we get to work.
Is that necessary?
I find it helps people get to the point quicker.
Okay, I had this dream about someone in the office, and I can't seem to get any work done.
Nora.
No. It was unusual.
Unusual?
And sexual.
Unusual and sexual. Are we talking Dave?
Look, I'd rather not say who it is.
Bradley?
But it made me think of this
Harris.
Woman.
Such.
No, in a way, I've never thought of her before.
I see. And the sex? How was it?
Mind-blowing.
Oh, Jake. Let me give you my 2 cents about office romances. They're dangerous.
Yeah.
On the other hand, it's partly the danger that makes them so tantalizing, so mind-blowing.
Really?
I sort of hesitate to tell you this because it kind of dates me, but if you've never made love on a mimeograph machine, you've just never lived.
So you're saying I should tell this person about it, maybe even ask her out?
What I'm saying is, time to work.
No, wait, Camilla, you have to finish the thought. It's like the buzzer in basketball. Once the shot's in the air,
Jake, look, you're unsure about this woman. So give it some time. If it's the right move for you to make, you'll sense it. And who knows? She may even make the decision for you.
Right.
Or she may not.
Right.
Hey. Thanks for the dry clothes, Nora. But, you know, I may have to borrow a wig if I'm gonna go home in this stuff. Hey, you stopped screaming. What'd you do?
I put on the Hindenburg.
They call that a disaster. They only had fire. We had fire and water. Look, they had ropes. We didn't have ropes. Lazy bastards.
This happened in New Jersey? Oh, the humidity.
Yeah, come in.
I got a van set to take them back to the hotel. Okay, up and at them.
Listen, again, I'm sorry about missing the premiere and about, well, being so disrespectful in the van. And, you know, and wait a second. I got to be honest with you. Could you just sit down for a sec? You know, when I took this story, I wasn't just interested in the Titanic. I was interested in meeting you people. I mean, your lives span the 20th century, and maybe it was naive of me, but I was thinking that maybe I could learn something from you.
Want some wisdom? Enjoy life while you're young. When you hit 98, it's all downhill.
Here. Here's $5. It always makes my grandson happy.
Edwina, I can't take your money.
No, please. It's yours. I found it in your kitchen drawer.
I'm sorry I called you flat-chested.
When did you say that?
I think it was during your big speech in the van.
Oh, yeah, that's what I was looking for.
Why don't you go load him up? I'll be out in a second.
You don't actually expect me to go out like this, do you?
Here, can borrow my raincoat.
Jeez. Thanks a lot.
Look, Nora, I don't know what you're expecting, but just because people are old doesn't make them interesting. They probably weren't interesting when they were young, either. I mean, look at Bradley. Do you think he's going to be any more interesting in 50 years than he is now?
I heard that. We're walking very slowly out here.
Let me tell you something. You didn't know your grandparents, but I lived with my grandmother all my life. And most of the time, she's a real pain in the ass, just like everyone else. But once in a while, she says something really brilliant or really funny. And it really makes me glad that she's still around. I think what you were looking for tonight wasn't wisdom. It was a personal connection.
Yeah, maybe.
So tell you what. Come over to my house whenever you want, and you can spend time with my grandmother.
Thanks, Suji. That's really sweet. But, you know, what about that whole white devil thing?
Look, you want a personal connection or not? Because I could really use a night off.
Yeah, okay, great. How's Saturday?
Perfect. Bath night. See ya.